Is your gym successful?
Yes.
What advice do you have for your Brazilian and any affiliate owner in the world? What are some of the things that you've learned that like make your gym successful?
It's a relationship business, not the movement business. We use movement to build relationships. And if people understand that, like there is a lot of actions that we, when we are so focused on movement, when we think about relationship first, there's a lot of behaviors that don't fit with that. So I think that's the main part of the reason that we could have a successful gym there is treating people well and thinking about the relationships.
What does that look like? Give me a specific. Like, how does that look? Practically, how does that look?
I was a very military trainer, like, and so focused on movement. And all I did for the first year and 2 years maybe, all I did was train my trainers, like the technical aspect, the watch, teach, and correct everything. And after that, I was like always trying to talk about them. Atendimento. This is a word that I don't have in English.
Say it again.
Atendimento.
Attention.
It's
focus.
Attention to clients, like dealing with clients.
I just translated it for you. Atendimento. Right?
Yeah, I think something more like a,
let me see. Do it one more time.
Atendimento.
No, I would say like personability, like being personable. Like relating to people.
Relating to people, yeah.
Your Portuguese is better than mine?
You know when you...
A little more practice than you do.
So in the practical side was myself. I needed to change the behavior in myself. And like sometimes I was... Because not with the intention. I would like to give everything to my clients to make their movement better. But I was impatient, or I show them like a little bit of insatisfaction with my attitude. I was rude to my clients, you know, and this is the kind of behavior that don't fits when you think about relationship first. So I want to make my clients move better for sure, but I won't have them there like forever. And if I have time, I will make them move better. But if I treat them not the way that they deserve, they will eventually go out, and I even can't do them move better.
You lose the opportunity.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's a really important point. Like there's a certain way to do these movements, and they should be done, you know, to the best that they can be executed.
For
but
sure.
But everyone starts at a different place, right?
Yeah.
And I think it's tough, like you said, as a trainer, to realize that, you know, maybe not everyone's end goal mm-hmm. is to back squat 400 pounds. You know, maybe their goal is somewhere, you know, just trying to do an air squat. And their learning curve is going to be so different. And it's hard not to just put them in like, okay, this is what they need to do this right. Why are you not doing this? It's like, well, you've got a backstory of things that are limiting you. And understanding that's tough.
Yes, it's tough. And it was my main fault, I think, is trying to give them everything at once. So now I think that I need to give them one thing on that day. And I am... more calm teaching classes, and the energy is high, and I'm there like it's so different now.